بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
To add to make a task easy and finish it with a good ending. Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khair.
Assalamu alaikum class, it's me Miss Maryam from the Educator Farooq Class campus. Today our first class of 2021-22. Class today date 6 May, day Thursday, class 7, subject science.
Okay students, before starting our class, we will first start dua. Kindly raise your hand for dua. Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khair. Class, today we are going to learn the unit number 1, nutrition in animals. Students, we have heterotrophic type of nutrition in animals. Because animals cannot make their own food, we all know that animals cannot make their own food. They depend on other organisms for their food. But plants, we know that the plants can make their own food because plants have the ability to make their own food. So that's why animals are called as heterotrophic animals. There are various types of processes, or you can say the animals, there are various types of animals they get the food from the other organisms. Because animals have the different structure, different body parts to utilize their food, to catch their food, to digest their food. They all are different from each other. That is why they are classified into different types. First, we will discuss about the herbivores. Herbivorous animals are those that eat only the plants or plant parts as their food. Why? Because they only have the ability to eat the plants because their teeth are designed as they can only chew the plants. That is why they only eat the plant, their stomach only digests the plants. Examples of them are, we all know that cows, goats and sheep are examples. Cow, goat and sheep, they are herbivorous animals. Now we will move towards the carnivorous. Carnivorous animals are those, they only eat meat. They only eat, they kill the other living organisms, or we can say other animals, to get their food. They kill them and eat them as their food. And examples of them are lion. Okay. Lion kill the other animals and eat them as their food. Now we have omnivorous animals. Omnivorous are those that eat both plants and animals as their food. Okay, so examples of them are we, human beings, because we eat vegetables and meat both. So we are the omnivorous, as well as bear. So examples of them are human and bear. Bear also eat plants and animals. Now we have parasites. Parasites are those animals that live inside or outside of the body of the host. Why we call the body of the host? Because they live on it or inside them and get the food with their host. And examples of them are tapeworm and roundworm. Okay, tapeworm and roundworm live inside of the body of host. Now the last one is scavengers. Scavengers are the organisms that depend on the decaying animals. What does it mean? The predators will kill their prey and eat them, and the remaining part of them will be eaten by some of the scavengers. And the example of them are crow. Crow is the scavenger. Animals in different kinds of and different kinds of food they eat. Now we have the new topic, process of nutrition. First you should know what is nutrition. Nutrition is a process. Basically it is a process. It is a process in which we eat the different types of food. Inside our body it will be converted into the energy, or you can say the fuel, which by the help of which we can do different types of function. Okay, so in this process there are five steps that are involved in this process. Number one is ingestion. What is ingestion? Ingestion is the step in which we eat the food. We say that ingestion is the taking in food. Okay, so different animals eat food with the help of different body parts, as we eat the food with the help of our mouth. And some of the unicellular organisms such as amoeba eat their food with the help of their body surface. So we have the different parts to eat their food, and the ingestion is the process of taking in food. Number two is digestion. So the food we eat, it cannot give us energy directly. First it has to convert into the simpler form. So digestion is the process in which this food will be converted into the simpler form. It will break down. Now the third step is absorption. Absorption is the process in which this simpler form of food will be absorbed by the cells of the body and will be transferred to the other body parts for functioning. Okay, now fourth step is assimilation. Assimilation is the process of absorption of the vitamins and minerals we get from our food. In this step, these vitamins and minerals will be absorbed by the body. Number fifth is ingestion. So the food we eat have the some useful ingredients, or we can say vitamins and minerals and proteins, and it also have some waste product. So after the process of this waste product will be excreted by our body, and this process is known as ingestion of food. So class, the process of nutrition depends on these five steps as we have learned. Okay class, I hope you got my lecture. Now the homework is question number one. Write down different types of mode of nutrition as we have discussed. Question number two, describe the process of nutrition. These two questions you have to write in your copy. And if you have any difficulty regarding my lecture, you can ask me in the Zoom class. And in your physical class, you have to bring the homework for checking. Thank you, class. Allah Hafiz.